Hi, it's Kate at the Sober School, and today I want to talk about something that I often hear from people when they're feeling really unhappy with their relationship with alcohol, but they're also feeling really stuck and not sure how to change or if they want to change. So something people often say to me is, I just really love drinking. Like, I love it. I love the taste of it. I love my wine. I'm a wine snob. Or I love, you know, expensive cocktails, or I love my after work beer. Whatever it is, they just love the taste of it and they can't imagine doing without it and not drinking. And there's a real sense of hopelessness there, because when you're so firmly in that place of really believing that you just love drinking and you know, you're very attached to it, it can feel really hard to change, really challenging, and the thought of going without it can seem hard and like some kind of deprivation. I know what it's like to feel this way, because I used to be in that place as well. And this is why I want to explore this a bit further with you today, because whilst you're in this mindset of, yeah, but I just really love drinking, it's actually quite hard to move forward and actually take action. So let's explore this in a bit more detail. So I think it's important to acknowledge that we weren't born loving alcohol. We're not born with an innate desire for it. In fact, if you think back to your first ever alcoholic drink, what was it like? I think for me, it was red wine and it made me gag. I thought it tasted disgusting. But the thing was, I also thought that drinking was cool. So guess what? I pushed on through and I learned to tolerate the taste and I taught myself to like it. Because I thought drinking was gonna make me fun and more confident and help me be the person that I wanted to be. The cultural beliefs we have around alcohol and the conditioning we have around what this drug does for us, well, that had sold me on the perceived benefits before I'd even picked up a glass. I thought that was what alcohol was going to do for me, so I was damn well going to try hard to like it and drink it and tolerate it. The reason we keep going and we keep persisting with this isn't because of the taste. We don't suddenly start loving it. No, it's always about the feeling. I don't think anyone tries wine for the first time and goes, delicious. But I think people do like the feeling, and it's always that feeling that we're chasing. I mean, think of it this way. If it was about the taste, you would have no problem just switching over to an alcohol-free version of your favorite wine or beer. Because the quality of these alcohol-free wines, beers, cocktails, whatever, they're amazing now. There's a terrific variety out there. It's nothing like it was when I quit drinking 7 years ago. The amount of, you know, products and the taste is so much better now than it ever was. So if it was about the taste, you'd just pick up one of those bottles. Here's something else that you might have experienced. So many of the women that I've coached to stop drinking have told me about their previous experiences with stopping or taking a break. And they might have done something like Dry January, and they've stopped for the month, and then February's come around, and they finally let themselves have that much longed for glass of wine. But guess what? It's a massive disappointment. It doesn't taste the way they remembered it tasting. But because they've spent all of January romanticizing the hell out of that wine, they just push through that disappointing taste, because actually they're chasing a feeling. Like I said, it's always about the feeling and not really about the taste. It's very easy and socially acceptable to say, oh, I'm a wine snob, or I'm a G&T girl. It's fine to say those things, but it's a lot scarier to say, actually, I have a really hard time relaxing on my own, or yeah, I'm not very confident, or I don't feel good in my own skin sometimes. It's harder to say that stuff. And by the way, if you, you know, if you're using alcohol for those things, or you're using alcohol because you have a hard time transitioning from your work day into home life, then that's okay. There's no judgment there, but just know that that's what you're doing. Because when you know that, you've got a pathway to change. You can think, okay, so what is the skill I need to learn in order to be able to do that thing on my own without alcohol? So this is where the real work of sobriety is. It's about stepping away from those big general statements like, ah, yeah, but I just really love drinking. It's about stepping away from those disempowering statements actually, and focusing on the nitty-gritty instead, and getting really clear about the feeling that we're chasing. It always comes back to a feeling. Taste just has very little to do with it. So I'm Kate B. In the comments below, I'd love to hear what you think about the taste issue. What was your first ever drink like? What did you think about it back then? I'd love to hear from you. I'm wishing you a great week. And I'll speak to you again soon.